Now that we've removed the element of danger, it's time for one of our favorite tools here on this old truck, the blue tip wrench. Now, one of the things you should never do, you should never turn on your oxygen like this, and then your gas, if my gas will come on, like that. What happened now? Too much. Never do this. And the reason you should never do that is because it goes BANG! And it scares the bejeebers out of everybody else in the shop. Somebody's already been in our door before. They got everything nice and stripped out. No, I didn't do it. I was not the cause, but I have the cure. There's nothing better than a blue tip wrench. Well, it's all loose. Oh, there it goes. Things are heavy. Come on, you. Time for the pry bar. Now, back in the 50s, they had these screw heads that looked kind of like a butterfly opening. I don't have one of those tools. I think there's a good reason why they stopped using them, too. Nobody else has those tools either. So, our old friend, the blue tip wrench, is going to help us get this floor pan out of here. Never do that. Don't try this at home. Do it at your neighbor's house. Now, in order to remove the shift lever from our style of top loader transmission, requires a special tool. I ain't got a special tool. We're gonna have to do it. Redneck Restorations, this old truck wrench. It's got a slot, two rounded ends. You get one screwdriver down in one corner, up on the opposite side, another screwdriver down in the other corner, and you're gonna push down, rotate it to the left. If you can! Oh, almost! Success! On to the next step. Well, now that should enable us to get our floor pan out of here. You got a cable down there for the two-speed rear end. I haven't seen a cable actuated one. There's our tunnel we need. Well, look at that. I ain't never seen nothing like that before in my life. Cable operated vacuum switch or a two-speed rear end. You need one? Got one. Now I must admit, it's the first time I've ever seen an intact headliner on one of these old trucks. I kind of like to keep it that way. We're blessed to have rust, because that's why it came apart. What we're going to do is very gently. They really did a favor for us by smashing the cab, and that it made this come away from the metal. It was glued up there, and then the glue is still holding fast to the rust. Uh-oh. I don't want to pry on any given point of it. I don't want to yank or pull too hard in any particular area. Ah. That's still glued up right there. But if I take this rubber strip off, that's one of the things that's so amazing. Rubber strips breaking into pieces. Still connected. You want to get your hand up in there and work only where it's connected. Don't grab and pull from somewhere. And there we go. Still pretty nice and supple. One headliner. Going home with me. Our dome light amazingly survived the smashing of the roof. Actually ripped one screw out of the sheet metal and didn't even bend the dome light itself. I had a Phillips screwdriver around here. Looks like if you smash the cab with the loader, it'll save you a lot of time taking the truck apart. Now, a little difficult to get to the wiring now. Deal with that another time. Here they are. Rub it against that sharp edge there a little bit. Give her a pull out the tongue. There you go. Need a dumb light? I got one.